Hi gents, how are you doing? So straight into it, I guess. Obviously finished the Nassau last week and finished the Imperial Guard Artillery now, so I'm not going to talk about them much because I think you've seen a limber before. Certainly, I don't know if the gun, but obviously it comes off, etc. And we finished the artillery piece and crew the other day. Now I've got them based. So I'll take them off here and we'll put them on the turning table. If you hang on till later on or the end of this video, what I'll do is I'll make sure that they're put in a light box and they should look rather nice. Just a quick chat about new purchases. I'm slowly working my way into some Germans. Late, very late war. So I've got this stuff, 1940-1945 from MIG. Hopefully, using my limited World War II skills, we're going to actually get some decent painted tanks out of it. My attempt at doing a comet wasn't the best, but it's on the table and it looks okay, so I'm happy with it. I've just ordered a late war, a 1944 or at least Mark IV, so that should turn up fairly shortly. When it does, we'll pop it on this on here for a bit of a review, see what I think of it, etc. The paints that come in this pack look quite nice. These are the MIG paints. They tend to be quite runny. I think you can see that. Very milky at the top. You've got to give them a good shake. I've noticed people using nail varnish shakers, and to be honest, it might be the best option with these because they are quite difficult to mix. Usually I turn things upside down as well if I'm going to have to do a lot of mixing, get the real thick medium up to the top. Anyway, we'll see how these work. It didn't help me much with the comment when I bought the British paints for that, but hey, you got to learn. So we'll move them out of the way. And to accompany them, oh, one thing, on the back, some nice paint schemes for different armour that you can get out of this this colour. So kind of useful, usual kind of MIG good quality product. The other one that I bought from AK a while ago, I don't know if I've put this up, but even more, and just a three pack to try and give you enough colours just to paint that paint scheme there, that camouflage. So I've got enough now for the rest of my life, I think, because there's an awful lot of tanks in there and I don't use an airbrush. So let's zoom in on these Cuirassiers. So these are my latest my latest topic, my latest interest, my latest project, painting project. So they're coming along quite nicely. Like I said before, I've got 12 of these. Haven't touched the skin, still got some work to do on the whites. Started putting a bit of red on some of them. If I just bring one of these guys over here, you can see a little bit more progressed with some of the colours on there, a bit more highlighting on the red, standing out a bit more. So quite pleased with the way they're going to look. They're going to look nice as a unit. A bit of mismatching some of the mouldings on these things. They're not the best, certainly around these areas, these knapsack kind of areas where this red and grey comes. The lines of what's grey, what's red could have been helped a lot more, I think. There seems to be some mismoulding in there. Still got to do the grey highlights, which will get rid of the... see if just zoom in on this guy. Some of the mistakes I've made on the top. Again, the faces haven't been done, but they already look okay because Perry faces are nice, right? And they've got a sun blush kind of skin tone with a wash on top. So already, so it's just a case of picking out the highlights and doing whatever. I think I made a mistake on the trousers. You see, it's light grey already. I think I might have already undercoated that in a darker grey, but for some reason I just slapped a lot of light grey on, and where to go from light grey, right? Anyway, they're ongoing, and yeah, I think they'll look quite nice. The Bugler, I am still deciding whether or not to try and put a video together about how I paint that horse into a dapple colour. If I don't get these finished next week, I think what I'll do is I'm going to put on the light box my Scots Greys. I've done a video previously with these guys in it, but I think you're justified in showing them in the lightbox because they will look nice, and I'd quite like to do that, so that's what I'm going to do. But those guys all got dappled horses, so you can see what this guy might look like if I don't get him done. But I've got to do it sooner or later, and the question is, do I video it for your consumption? So there's these guys, I suppose. You can see the difference in colours in reds, I think, there, as I was pointing out. What's this big monster in the background? Well, I can't remember if it's foreground or what it is really, but it's certainly in the background here, isn't it? So let's just shift these cavalry. Little painting technique I use is, because I'm halfway through the colours on these cavalry, what I do is, if I need to do red or anything like that on them all, the ones that I've painted, I simply move over to one side of the disc. The ones I haven't, I keep on the other side of the disc. Keeps everything kind of smart, if you know what I mean, in that way. So, this thing, yeah, it's a bit of a saga ongoing. It's been a quite, I mean, for the money, I can't remember what it cost, but it wasn't a lot. And kind of put some sand on it and undercoated it. But look at the size of it, eh? You know, when they're put together or are kept separately, quite a decent kind of looking piece of kit, isn't it? Zoom out. Yeah, and the roof comes off as well. Put your figures in. Don't know what I'm going to do in there, maybe a big rug, something like that. I'll overdo it, no doubt. But really, I could just do with getting on the table. I do have the chateau as well. And I don't know if anybody knows, but I could do with a sign in German or French or something to put on there. But I don't know any companies that would provide that. There must be out there. It's just looking, I think. Maybe I'm just lazy. So there you go. I suppose it's what it's looking like. It's as progressed as I've got it. Again, you know, I've been trying to get things progressing on the toy soldier front, but that wouldn't make a nice piece of kit to put on the battlefield. I think when I noticed, you know, you put that kind of in front of it, and okay, maybe the wrong period, maybe not. But it does look nice, doesn't it? It's a good substantial piece of kit. So I really should get the chateau put together as well. Anyway, thoughts for the future. And that's it for this week. It's 7 minutes into the video. I think that's long enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these guys on the turntable. So I guess I'll speak to you next week. If you do like, do like. If you do want to subscribe, please do. Always happy to grow the channel. And I'll speak to you soon. Cheers, bye.